So now you've got all this cash on the balance sheet, and you've got all this runway. But this building a network of hydrogen chargers and coordinating the building of hydrogen trucks and satisfying a bunch of customers seems like an awful lot of work. And then, I'm not sure exactly the date you announced it. What date did you announce that you're going to take on Ford's F-150 pickup truck and Elon's Cybertruck and the Rivian? Rivian is the other.
Rivian.
Yep. Sorry, Rivian. So now you decide, F it. I'm going to create an F-150, the best-selling car in the United States, I think, and obviously the best-selling truck. Why would you take on more work?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
So here's the reason why. Our trucks are a gravy train with money. That's where all the money comes from, is our big semi trucks, right? The problem is 90% of Americans will never own a semi truck. And so your portfolio of investors can be very limited. And we wanted to go and build a company that's going to be worth $500 trillion over, say, 10 or 15 years. And if you're limiting yourself to 10% of the market, you'll never do it, no matter how good your numbers are. The reason why people love Apple, everyone touches their product. Why do they love Google? Everyone touches their product. So what I did is I knew day one, once we started coming out, we had all this gravy train coming in from the semi-truck program. My question was, okay, that's great, but I'll never touch the average consumer. So therefore 90% of investors will probably never invest in me. So I needed to touch the consumer. And so the truck is for the profit, the semi-truck, the pickup truck's for the consumer. And the consumer is the one who is part of the Robinhood portfolio, is part of the family office or whatever. And that's where all the valuation of the company comes from.
Because they touch your product. Are you saying you're going to do it profitably, or that it's a loss leader, or it's profitable? You intend to be profitable with it. What will that retail for? Have you announced the pricing and the launch date of that?
Yeah, 60 to 90K. So very reasonable in the price. And we'll have about somewhere right around about 20% margin on that. And it hits next year. So we'll be in production at the end of next year.
And are you taking the same approach? You're going to build it with a partner as opposed to...
Yes.
So who's that partner? Who's going to build a pickup truck?
That's not been announced yet, but it'll be coming out soon. That's it. That's probably one of the biggest announcements that the entire investment community wants to know about Nikola. And that hits very soon.
Okay.
That's a huge deal. And it'll be built at their factories through their supply chain. You're talking about billions of dollars in saving with the ability to build hundreds of thousands of these without any type of growing pains.
And it's going to be hydrogen, or is it going to be battery?
Both. You can order either way. You can choose battery or hydrogen.
But with hydrogen, how would you fill the tank if you have yet to build the network?
Well, in some states like California, have hydrogen. You already have a lot of hydrogen stations. But we have 700 hydrogen stations going up right now throughout America. And it's just going to take time. We won't sell the hydrogen in every market. We're going to say, look, as soon as our station comes online, then you can buy the hydrogen version there.
Why would somebody buy the hydrogen? Because it seems, like we said earlier, that battery kicks hydrogen's ass in low load situations. We take that as a given.
It does.
Who has a pickup truck that's going to be going for 10 hours hauling something huge? That seems like a tiny part of the market. What is that market?
No, about 30 to 40% of the pickup truck market actually uses their truck for work and pulls trailers. So in that situation, you do not want a battery truck. If you pull a trailer with a Tesla Model X right now, you lose about 60, 70% of your range. So you're talking about getting you can't put a trailer on there and go more than 100 miles on a Cybertruck without it dying, or 150. So the idea here is that if you can, with hydrogen, you can allow that truck to pull a trailer. You know, it'll give you a 600 mile range without a trailer, and about a 300 mile range with it. And so it's made for the construction world, the people pulling trailers, the business owners, the guys going to job sites, or those trying to power a job site, or those hauling big loads. And that's what it's for on that's what it was made for the hydrogen version.
And so you will, on the hydrogen side, is there a hydrogen pickup truck out there today?
No, we're the first one.
Yeah. So you're not going to be competing with anybody on the hydrogen side for the pickup truck, but you will be competing with Rivian and the Cybertruck eventually.
Yeah.
On that side. But you're not going to be building it yourself. You're going to be putting your innards, your drivetrain, your batteries, et cetera. But I assume you're not making your battery packs either, right? That's your lightweight.
No, we do.
You do make your own battery packs.
We do make our own battery packs. That's a key element because of the cost. The battery packs, 30% of your vehicle's cost, or 40. So it's one of the most important things to actually bring in-house. And so we do make our own battery packs. The whole truck is our design, is our build. But another manufacturer is going to actually be spitting it out on their assembly line.